Joey's on right now. You don't mind if I check his phone?
Not at all. Totally.
Thanks. I know it's such an awful thing to do on a first date, but it's late in the fourth quarter of a playoff game.
No worries.
Do you mind if I wear this earpiece? I promise it won't be distracting.
Sure.
I'm making the worst first impression, aren't I?
Not at all.
It's just because it's the playoffs, like, usually normal.
So what's the score?
Steelers by 7.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no, it's no big deal. It's just a game, right? So, enough about football. Let's hear about Mr. Mystery. Harry told me tons about you.
Man, the pressure's on now.
I can check one more time.
No worries.
Come on!
What?
Oh, nothing. It's just that this line is Chubb is huge, running lane. He fumbles the handoff. Sure, Lane should recover, but come on, this is the playoffs. You can't just cough up the ball like that. Now you're starting in a third and long. The whole season's riding on one play.
I hope I'm
gonna be what? Pass the ball!
What's wrong?
It's a third and long. Who runs to him on third and long? And Mayfield suddenly forget that he has an arm? Oh my god, I'm being loud, aren't I?
No.
Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Here, I'll make it up to you. After dinner, I'll buy you dessert at this tiny little bistro on 11th that nobody knows about. I think you'll just pass the ball! Jeez, people in the fourth down, pass the freaking ball!
Listen, we could go to a bar with a TV or something.
Oh, no, I wouldn't want to do that to you. The game's pretty much over anyways. Ooh, I got a little feeling right there, didn't I? Let's order.
Oh, Harriet said we should definitely try that. Or we could try something else.
They lost.
Oh, I'm sorry.
They lost. The season's over.
Well, I'm sorry. Is there anything I can do?
The Browns suck.
Oh, no, they don't suck.
They do. They suck.
We're just having a bad season.
The Browns suck.
The Browns suck.
Hi.
Hello.
It's great to meet you.
The pleasure's all mine.
So where are you from? I trust in Jackson.
Well, I was born in the mountains of Guam and raised on the shore of New Jersey.
You want to order some appetizers?
Anything to which your happiness for your beautiful lips.
The shrimp cocktail looks good.
Shrimp, a creature of the ocean, the ocean which is not nearly as beautiful as the ocean you realize.
Okay, can I ask you sort of a blunt question?
Anything to which your heart desires.
Yeah. Are you going to be like this for the rest of the dinner?
Whatever could you mean?
You know, all creepy and nauseating.
Yes.
Hi.
Hi.
It's great to meet you.
Same here. Listen, I was wondering if you were free next Friday.
I think so. Why?
Well, if dinner goes well tonight, I wanted to go ahead and schedule a second date.
Okay, sure.
See, because here's the thing. My parents are having a housewarming party at their new place on May 1st, and if you and I hit it off and end up getting serious, that party could be the perfect opportunity for you to meet them. So I'd like to squeeze in 6 days before him, because if we don't, my parents might be skeptical of our relationship, which, after you pop the question, could then make anyone uncomfortable during the ceremony, which could then carry over to our 3 week honeymoon and cause a melt, and more importantly than anything else, it could really take the toll on Little Madison.
Wow.
What? What is it? Do you not like the name Madison? We could change it. I mean, my second, third, and fourth option are Fiona, Ryan, and Apple.
No, those are great names.
Is something on your mind? You can always tell your little bunny rabbit anything.
The problem is, you seem to have a whole relationship figured out. We just met 30 seconds ago. I mean, you got everything pinned down with a wedding dress.
Does that make you uncomfortable? Because if it doesn't, we pick it up now.
Hi.
Hi there.
It's great to meet you.
Me too.
So, how long have you lived in the city?
Almost a year. It feels good though.
3 years for me. It's a great city.
Definitely. So, what do you like most about it?
So, what do you like most about living here?
Well, I love walking my dog in the park, especially on a pretty day.
I'm a little different, I guess. I'm more the kind of guy that likes walking his dog in the park on a pretty day.
No, I like that too. I just said so.
Do you have a dog?
Yes.
Oh, you should get one. After all, we are man's best friend.
Are you listening to me at all?
Do you like watching TV?
No.
Me too! Sometimes I like to curl up with a bag of popcorn and get my Seinfeld on. Like Seinfeld?
You really are listening to me.
Me too! Have you ever heard his joke about the airline food?
No.
What's the deal with airline food? Hilarious. Classic. Cracks me up every time.
That's a good one. Listen.
I'm telling you, Seinfeld is still the funniest show on television. Serenity now! No soup for you. Newman.
This is ridiculous.
I mean, his comedy is just a gift from the gods, you know what I mean? Every time I see a show or one of his movies, I'm just blown away. Have you ever seen the B-movie?
Yes, I have.
You haven't? Stop what you're doing and rent it now. That movie is so great. It's got deep puns galore, and the puns are really interesting. Suing the big guys in the honey industry and taking down the industry. I mean, I'm telling you, he's the funniest guy on television. He reminds me of me a lot, actually.
Hello?
We have the same sense of humor. My roommate, Bill, he says that I'm the funniest guy he's ever met.
He really said that, because...
I mean, he's entitled to his opinion, right? Sure, I'm funny, but I've got my personality flaws, too.
Really?
Like, sometimes I'm too funny.
Really?
People don't realize when I'm being serious. Do you believe that? Anyway, I'm talking up a storm here. I'm telling too much about me. Tell me about you.
Or I could just leave now, since you're a self-centered jerk.
I'm a Capricorn myself.
Hi. It's great to meet you.
You too. Julia's told me a lot about you.
She's a great girl.
Yeah, she is. We've been friends for like 6 years or something. So much fun to be around.
Where'd you meet? In school?
Yeah, we played soccer together. Both second stringers. Keeping the bench nice and warm for everyone else. No, seriously. Julia's one of my favorites. And she has great taste. So what she told me about you, I was definitely on board.
That's very sweet.
No, really. I've been looking forward to this. For a while.
I'm flattered.
So, are you hungry?
I'm about ready. I'm pretty hungry, too. Listen, I can see you stealing me. You don't have to play it off like you're not.
What? What are you talking about?
See here, you just stole a plate. I'm sitting right here.
What a cruel accusation.
Accusation, I'm watching you steal their sugar package right now. How can you honestly believe I don't notice?
Look, I don't know what your problem is with me as a person, but this is very insulting. I better go.
Wait, look, if you stop stealing things, I'll get off your case, okay?
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great. So, where are you from? I mean, I like sports as much as the next guy, but this girl was completely unhinged.
Yikes.
He was so over the top and freaky. I'm pretty sure he compared my eyes to shrimp.
Yikes.
Well, what about that girl Julia set you up with? Julia has great taste. She can't have been that bad.
Yes. Remind me to thank Julia the next time I see her for setting me up with a kleptomaniac. I mean, seriously, the girl can go in conversation without pocketing everything in sight.
Well, what about that guy in the bookstore? What's his name? Lewis. He seemed promising.
Yes, Lewis. God's gift to mankind. The most self-absorbed human being I've ever had the displeasure of speaking to. He wasn't even listening to me.
I mean, my prospects have been hopeless thus far.
You know, he needs other things.
I may as well just give up now.
No point in trying anymore.
Listen, bud, I've known you, since pre-K, and you're a hopeless romantic. You can't just give up that easy. You deserve to find happiness.
So you listen, it was only two bad dates. There's so many other fish in the sea. You gave up that easily.
I guess you're right.
That's the spirit.
Yes, girl.
Now get back out there.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Same here.
So tell me about yourself.
Well, I can sum it up easily. My greatest passion is doing anything and everything that lets me live on the edge. For me, it's all about intensity, going for growth, taking chances.
That's a good outlook.
Yeah, it's all about living to the extreme! There's a saying, you know, if it's not extreme, it's not worth dreaming about.
I like it.
Yeah, it took me a couple months to get the rhyming perfect.
Sure.
You know that Billy Joel song, Why Do I Go to Extremes? It's like that song's made. That's how much I love being extreme!
It's a good song.
It's my favorite.
Extreme?
Extreme!
So, are you a snowboarder, or an off-road biker, or...?
I don't know. I'm way too busy with work to do anything like that.
So what do you do?
I'm an accountant.
An accountant?
I know. It doesn't sound too extreme! But trust me, it gets pretty extreme!
Really?
Yeah, I mean, just look at tax forms, for example. The W-9, the 1099, popped up intense. Sure, we all know that the Form 1040 is crazy, but the Form 1040 ES... off the hinsel.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I said it's a little joke around the office that the ES and 1040 ES actually stands for EXTREME standard. Sort of known for my puns.
That's not really a pun.
But beyond accounting, I still like to stay extreme in my spare time. Like something a normal person does, I like to take it up a notch.
Really?
Yeah, wanna see? Here. Alright, so a normal person would walk like this. But this is how I walk. Or a normal person would forgive it like this. This is how I or a normal person would floss like this. But this is how I floss. Blows your mind, right?
Did you just floss on a date?
Oh man, that was so rude of me. I really wasn't thinking. Here.
Hi.
Hi.
I've been looking forward to this for a while now.
Me too. Sorry about all the scheduling.
Whatever, it's cool. Hold on. I forgot you.
What's up? What's wrong?
Oh, it's the silly little thing. I've got this pill that I need to take or else I get all weird. I know it was around here somewhere. You know, whatever. It's cool.
You sure? We could go to a pharmacy or something.
Nah, it's fine. It's just precautionary drug. It won't kill me if I don't take it for one night. I just maybe a little out of whack. You probably won't even be able to sell. So, anyway.
Anyways.
Nice to finally meet you.
The feeling's mutual.
Oh, yes. It's so awesome to finally put a face to the name.
Yeah, seriously.
You're funny. Ooh, you're cute. Oh, he's not that cute. You just haven't been out in a while. That's not true. He is good looking. Shh, you're embarrassing yourself. Quit freaking out. What? Why are you jumping all over me? She started it. Now, girls, don't fight. What would your father think? Oh, let him fight.
Are you okay?
You stay out of this. Hey, lay off of him. We just met him. I'll let him handle himself. Ooh, ah, ah, ah. All right. Who brought the monkey? Not me. I did! I'm so sorry! A monkey? Come on! You better behave yourself, young lady, or you're grounded! Get off her case, woman! Oh, ah, ah, ah.
Hey, are these the pills?
There they are! Took you long enough!
Is everything okay?
Okay. Okay. I think we're starting to kick in.
Great.
In a couple of seconds, I'll settle into a single personality. Don't worry. 9 times out of 10, it's one of the normal ones.
But with my luck, she was nice.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Same.
That's order. I'm sorry.
Me too.
Wow, this menu is huge.
Yeah, I can never decide when the menu's so big. I can be picky.
Well, I think I'm gonna get the pork chops. What about you?
I don't know. Nothing really jumps out at me.
Really? How about you try pot roast?
No, too moist.
Oh, well then you can try the shrimp scrampi.
Too moist.
Oh.
I actually have a bit of hydrophobia.
Hydrophobia?
It's the fear of dampness or moisture.
Oh, well, then how about the Asian Parmesan?
Porphyrophobia.
What's that?
The fear of the kind of purple.
Oh, well, then you could get the cheese plate.
I probably shouldn't have claustrophobia.
What's that?
The fear of constipation.
How about the sushi?
Ichthyophobia. It's the fear of...
raw fish. Yeah, I got it. How about this? It's a Hawaiian fish and it's not raw. Let's just see if I can pronounce it right. Humu humu nuku nuku aqua.
That actually looks delicious.
Great.
But I actually suffer from a very rare case of kiponchalipophilophobia.
Which is?
The fear of long words.
All right, how about this? Just peanut butter and jelly.
Sorry.
What could possibly be wrong with a peanut butter and jelly?
I actually have a very rare case of arachnophobia.
What's that with your sandwiches?
The fear of peanut butter sticking to the roof of your mouth.
So, what can be?
Not much. I do have zero.
Zero.
Food.
So, if you have all these dietary issues, then why would you invite me to dinner?
Good question.
Listen, why don't we just skip this and go see hockey game or something?
Yeah, pacifist.
Mini golf?
Asthma.
See musical.
Depends on the musical. I actually have a lore phobia.
Zero.
Pass.
Right, so what would you like to do?
I actually have a few ideas.
Great.
But I have a cytophobia.
All right, how about I'll decide for you? How about we just call it a night?
I can't.
Why?
A new devotee.
What's that, if you're staying single for the rest of your life?
Actually, yeah. Although it is probably best we end this date now when it comes to my diphenophobia.
Fear of?
Dinner conversations.
All right, well in that case, have a good night.
You too, one second.
So, what do you do for a living? You pull rope. Look, I respect your profession. I think it's noble what you do. The world needs more people who climb invisible ladders. But I really don't see how it's appropriate to bring your work on a date. Oh yeah, quite the storm in here. I'm gonna use the restroom. You know, I'm not leaving. I'm taking my coat with me because it might get cold in it. Yeah, cold like that. No, you stay. Look, I don't know what that is. Oh my god! A box! A huge glass box! Falling from the sky! No! Ow.
Sorry.
That's alright. I should stop moping anyway.
So what are you gonna do?
I think I'm gonna break.
What do you think I should do?
No. I think you should get back in the game.
It's not too soon for that.
It's never too soon for that.
Are you sure that's a good idea?
What's a good idea? This quiz went cute on a triple leaderboard score. Oh, really, really good idea. Sorry, you were saying?
You really think I should start dating again?
Yes.
Right away.
Rebounding is a crucial part of social health.
There's no other option. You've got to find someone to distract you from her.
All right, I'll do it.
Excellent.
That's the spirit.
And even if it doesn't work out, we learned a valuable lesson for today.
What's that?
3 times 2 is 30.
After you obliterate someone 62-7, you lose the feeling in your thumbs.
Thanks.
You're a real pal.
What do you know?
Great to meet you.
It's great to meet you too.
So on your listing it said you're a doctor.
Yeah.
That's really fantastic.
Thank you. It's rewarding work. A lot of work actually, but I feel like I'm making a difference, as cliche as that sounds. Oh, what do you do again? Sorry, I forgot.
Oh, I work at a bank.
Oh, hold on a second. I gotta take this. I'll be really quick.
No problem.
Thank you. Stacy! What's up, girl? No! What? Yeah! Yes! No, it's Ellie! Who's there? A little old lady who?
So, how Violet said you
Now that you probably don't play cello, but still have mine.
Cello, more like hello.
Oh!
I'm in the Joker, you're alright.
What was that?
What was what?
You kicking.
Oh, that's just how I kick up my sentences with a little bit more juice. Sometimes you gotta add a little bit of punctuation.
Awesome.
Hey, you got your own punctuation too, babe.
Yes, that was my light way of having a taut thump thump.
You're so light.
True, although you do wear more makeup than me.
Now listen, before we hop on this train called love, I need you to understand the priorities of an international rock sensation. And those priorities are the music, groupie makeouts, lady love, cool ranch burritos. Wait, those priorities are the music, cool ranch burritos, groupie makeouts, lady love.
I'm the same way.
I can see that look in your eyes. You guys are saying, play me a song right now.
My eyes are not saying that.
Oh, I probably shouldn't anyway. I haven't tuned up in a while.
I do not want you to play a song in this restaurant.
Oh, that's all right. Anything for my lady love.
No, seriously, it's okay. Oh my goodness, no, please. Oh, listen, I don't know if you noticed, but there are other people in this restaurant. Guitar Hero, seriously?
Unbelievable, right? She handles like a dream.
It's not even plugged in.
What? I can't hear you. The music is overpowering.
I give up.
No, you don't.
It's hopeless out there.
I'm sure it's not that bad.
I have zero optimism for the human race.
What if any of these people give birth?
You just have to keep trying.
Rebounding is important.
But the success rate is always low.
Everyone knows if you want to make an omelet, you gotta shoot for the moon.
I think you got that wrong.
Wait a second. Is that Kim?
Are you my ex-boyfriend's best friend?
I get a call from the moon. Keep trying, Kim.
Hey. Okay?
Yeah, they're fine.
Alright, Scrabble Queen. You just sit back and watch as I run back this kickoff for the game winner.
Yes. Oh, what happened? So when I tackle your own 10-yard lines, do you get points for that? I wasn't aware of that. That's weird.
Shut up.
See, when your profile said you were into living history, I thought that meant you occasionally into the war reenactment. Not that you'd come to a day pretending to be a pirate.
Pretending?
Yes, pretending.
I'd be as real as Sea Dog as you'll ever meet.
And do all real pirates shop at 8 p.m.?
Arr.
Hi.
Hello.
So, on your listing, it said you're a psychiatrist.
Oh, no. That was a typo.
Oh, you're a psychologist?
Psych.
Ah.
Yeah, I meant to call a favor to fix that, but I forgot the number.
So, what's it like?
Oh, man. The predatory field can be rough. Just last week, I ran into Star, so I was getting into sunburn on July 8th. So I had to cancel my trip to Cancun.
Ah.
I know what you're thinking. Sunburns are the worst.
Right.
See how I knew what you're thinking?
So, how did you first decide you'd become a psychologist?
I remember exactly what it hit me. I was a freshman in college, and I envisioned that I was going to fail math exam. And I failed. Isn't that amazing?
Yes.
That's the moment I needed. And 4 years later, I became a psychic. That's another big change.
But all of those are actions you can control.
How about I give you a free reading?
That's okay, I'm fine.
Oh no, I insist.
I don't really think I feel comfortable with this.
Does he feel comfortable with this? It is decidedly so.
Alright.
Lend me your left hand.
Interesting, very interesting. This crease between your thumb and your pointer is your lifeline. Like to see a big arch and a clear impression. That indicates vibrancy and health. Yours is, well, that's not great. But here, if we look at the edge of your hand beneath the pinky, that's your marriage mark. If the line goes up, as yours does, yes, well, it seems like you won't be getting married anytime soon. Oh, but you do have a second marriage mark. That indicates that you would be involved in a rather messy, tumultuous love triangle. Won't that be surprising? Oh, but if we look at the center of your hand, I can see that you like sports. Is it true that you like sports?
I like sports.
I see that right here. Sports. Let's see. Your history mind is located over here. Sometimes you have to... Okay, there we go. When you were a teenager, did you go to high school?
Yes!
That sounds about right.
Listen, can I have my hand back? You haven't really told me anything, it's not obvious.
Oh, here comes the big finale.
That's okay, I'm fine.
The main line is located on the top of the hand, beneath the fingers. But yours is remarkably different. How are you getting a reading?
Ooga chaka, ooga chaka, ooga chaka. There we go. Are you ready? You have two sisters, one redhead, the other blonde. You're 5'8". You love movies. You consider yourself politically independent, and you're a Virgo rising. Well done.
But that's amazing. Every last one of those things was completely true. How could you possibly know all of that?
I see it in your hand.
Wow. What else do you know? Can you tell my future?
But of course. When you die, you will donate your organs. Your credit card is a Visa and an 8235. And after April 30th, you can no longer purchase two large one-topping pizzas for the price of one.
Can I have my wallet back?
All signs point to no.
This may sound a bit insensitive, but how old are you? What's your favorite animal?
No, I'm serious. I really want to know your age.
I like elephants.
Look, I think there's been a misunderstanding. When your profile said you were still in school, I assumed you meant college. That's very like.
Do you have a scar? I have a scar. Do I see it?
No, that's not right.
I got your kid book. Do you see it?
Honestly, how old are you?
This night. Will you be my girlfriend?
Your girlfriend?
Does Katie Johnson always bring boring water to school? And Courtney Schuler smells like horses.
You've got a lot of girlfriends.
Yeah.
Will you be my girlfriend? Sure, but only if you pay for it.
Okay.
You sort of have the wrong idea. On multiple levels.
These prices be outrageous!
Look, I'm not interested in male companionship. Or pirate companionship.
Companionship? Your skull be hollow. Nar, I am searching for a scurvy crew of buccaneers to join the quest for that hidden treasure of crossbones. Go!
I gotta go. My ship is double parked.
Yeah, all right.
Oh, deja vu all over again.
You can say that again.
Deja vu all. Never mind.
All right. So, you're dating again?
You could say that. You too.
Mm-hmm.
That guy. So, how's it going?
Oh, great. Really fantastic.
Me too. Having a great time.
All right. No, it's awful.
Yeah, we can find the same.
So, I was wondering if we should, okay, I'm not saying we should get back together just because the dating pool sucks.
Yeah.
Although it feels less like a dating pool and more like a kiddie pool. You know how kiddie pools are mostly for women.
No, I get it.
Right. So I think it's unhealthy.
Unhealthy to start a relationship out of desperation. I agree.
Good.
So this is what I was thinking. We were boyfriend and girlfriend before we were ever friends. So What if we start at scratch just as friends and take it a day at a time?
Day at a time, I like it.
All right.
Let's give it a shot.
So, you want to get ice cream?
Believe it or not, I do like ice cream.
I thought you might.
Please don't tell me you're psychic now.
Just one stipulation before we do this whole friendship shot.
Yeah?
We set fire to your Captain McCallum costume.
Deal.
I heard that, and I curse your merry souls! Ahoy there! BESC Roman Scalawag, because I'd be in dire need of a person.
Check, please.
Vin Diesel movies are exciting. This undershirt is exciting.
What if we made a 50 TV star with undershirt?
I'm calling Hollywood.
Get this though. I have a blind date tonight too.
Nice.
Yep.
So, remind me why we go on these. We've had like comically bad luck with blind dates.
Hey, I mean, we met on blind date.
We met on blind dates at the same restaurant with other people. That's a blind date from Asterix. Plus, we eventually broke up twice. Double Asterix.
I mean, without my dates, we wouldn't be besties now.
And only my bestie would know how much I love the word bestie. Just to make sure, it's not weird that we're talking about this, right?
Not as weird as an ex-couple that folds laundry together.
True.
Hold on a second. We are so romantic comedy right now. Two best friends, folding laundry together. Everything's platonic. Until the girl innocently passes the bag of sweatpants.
Hey there, best friend. You mind handing me those sweatpants?
They're handy. Oops.
Whoops. Takes your hand there.
The camera zooms in as they walk past the pivot of spoken passion.
Choose Celine Dion.
Well, I can't see it.
Get me Matthew McConaughey.
You would not be played by Matthew McConaughey.
Get me Samuel L. Jackson.
Hey, you're going to Kim and Hayes wedding tonight, right?
Yeah, I do.
Yep.
Nice. I'll probably bring this girl on you tonight, because she took me to be awful.
Really?
Yeah.
What time is your date?
8. When's yours?
8.
What time is yours?
Give me the shirt. Give me the shirt. The shirt.
Stop.
Hi.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you.
Same here.
I like your shirt.
Thanks.
This guy Frank I knew in college had the same one.
Frank's a copycat.
Totally. So, what's your favorite hobby?
Well, my new guilty pleasure is karaoke.
I love karaoke. I used to go with this friend who'd sing Don't Stop Believin' literally every time. Actually, coincidence, it's the same guy with the shirt.
Frank?
Frank.
Frank's got great taste in shirts and dumb hobbies. So, how long have you lived in town?
About a year. I moved to be closer to my best friends. Tracy from high school, Denise from preschool, Frank, Janine, Claire, Frank, Allison.
What about Frank?
Oh, right, Frank. Frank is one of my closest friends.
I figured.
You know how it's impossible for guys and girls to be just friends? Frank and I are the one exception.
That's great.
I mean, we did date once. A long time ago, but just for a few weeks. Or it might have been a couple of months. 8 years, but I don't want to talk about him because it's bad for me to talk about an ex. Frank taught me that.
Smart idea.
Thank you so much for listening to me.
Hold on a second, did you just say thank you?
What? No, I said thank you. Anyways, what were you talking about a second ago? I'm drawing a blank.
Okay, you definitely said Frank that time.
What? I did not! This is freaking ridiculous.
May I take your order?
Oh, yes, I would love to order.
Seriously? You broke up years ago. Quit stalking me.
Who was that guy?
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
Likewise.
All right, I have to ask you right off the bat. Is it true what Cheryl told me about you, that you're fluent in a bunch of different languages?
Yeah.
That's so cool.
Thanks.
Seriously, like, everybody I know just knows English, and you'd be like 8 words in Spanish and French.
Really?
Yeah, including me. Like, if I went to Mexico right now, I'd probably only be able to find a bathroom and a library.
I'm sure you know more than you think. I get rusty all the time.
So how many do you know?
I'm not sure. I lost count a while back.
Are you serious? I'm genuinely impressed. Wait, so would it be strange on a date to ask if it's on the languages?
I'd rather not.
Oh, come on, please.
I don't want to look like I'm showing off.
No, just a few.
All right, I'll give you a sample. Let's see, if I wanted to say, it's a pleasure to meet you in Latin, I would say, a postmortem carpe diem esse cum laude.
Really? That sounds familiar.
It's a fairly common expression. I studied the classics in college for 3 years.
Well, you definitely know better than me. What else?
Well, there's Italian. For instance, if I wanted to tell you, you look beautiful in the color green, I would say, really grazie in eroi di caprio calzone.
Did you just say DiCaprio?
Yeah, that's color, or hue.
Oh.
Then in German, if I wanted to say, excuse me, waiter, my soup is cold, I would say, auf Wiedersehen, was wird's leer auf Hosen.
Hold on a second.
In French, hold on a second would be loosely translated as, de juve, de voie, à la baguette.
Wait.
In Hebrew, that's dreidel, dreidel, dreidel.
Okay, stop. This is insulting. I mean, if you were joking, that would be one thing, but it honestly seems like you're trying to convince me that you know all these different languages. Do you know a single foreign language, or are you just a terrible liar?
Taco.
Hi.
My fellow American.
Nice to meet you.
It is an honor and a privilege to spend this moment with a magnificent citizen of our country.
Yeah, likewise. So, I'm going to take a guess and say that you're in the politics.
Now is the time to abandon partisan politics. We must reach across the divide, reach across the aisle, and at long last, dispense with the same old Washington games. Politics? Not if I have anything to say about it.
So politics.
My record on the issue has been clearly stated.
Okay, so where are you from?
I was born in a small Missouri town called Soot. Soot is a humble town full of hardworking families, rolling prairies, and oats. The first thing you learn as a citizen of Soot is the difference between a good oat and a bad oat. A good oat has character. A good oat lasts for years. A good oat feeds families. A bad oat? Well, a bad oat can leave a bitter taste in a young child's mouth. A bad oat cannot be trusted. A bad oat will destroy your home and steal your take-home pay.
Powerful oat.
Can I start chocolate anything?
Sure, I'll have the goat cheese truffle.
And for you?
My esteemed colleague wishes for goat cheese truffles. I, on the other hand, wish to improve our schools, reduce deficit spending, and keep the government out of the pocket of big business.
Coming right up.
Okay, this is getting...
I've traveled all across this fine land, and I've shaken the hands of real Americans just like you. Take the 60-year-old mill worker I met in Stone Ridge, Ohio. His name was Gort. Now, Gort may have a ridiculous name, but Gort does not have a ridiculous heart. Gort spoke to me about what we need in this country. That what we need is a leader who leads. Not a leader who doesn't lead. That would be a waste of the four first letters of leader.
Okay, let's change.
For the young woman I met in Great Bend, Kansas, her name was Lynn, and she was a zookeeper. She may have shoveled crap for a living, but she was not
free. Please stop. You're on a date. This is bizarre.
A date which will live in infamy.
Wow, that was offensive. Listen, I don't mind politics. I'm actually glad that we're dedicated to a person in the country. I'd just rather not talk about it right now. Can we please change the subject?
It is time for a change.
No late conversation topic.
Time for a new beginning.
No.
A new dawn.
And Ruth Hayes and I approve this, Desi.
You know, I just remembered something I feel you should know. I'm not registered to vote.
You've got to be freaking kidding me!
Call me!
Hi!
I lost 300 pounds.
Wow.
You don't believe me, do you?
No, I believe you.
Well, believe this! Some people swear by it, sausage diet. Others swear by the Atkins. Me, I swear with three words. Determination. Hard work. Onions.
Onions?
I swear every day with onions to me. Then for lunch, I do an onion lunch, which is a pile of onions on the other two slabs of onions. And for dinner?
Let me guess, an onion.
An onion!
Does it ever get boring for you?
Well, once a week I splurge for a low-fat onion sorbet. Mm. But it was all worth it, because I've got 4 years of onions to do! Do you know where most of the weight goes from grandpa's overweight?
I don't know.
Hips? Gut, thighs, wrong, wrong, wrong. The answer, the skull. Now that's where it counts. 112 looks right here.
I didn't know that was possible.
Are you kidding me?
No.
Are you kidding me?
No.
I should also mention that the rest of the weight went to my waist.
Do you carry those pants around with you everywhere?
What, these pants? No, not really. Sell them in occasionally. Infrequently? Sometimes?
Always.
Yeah, all the time.
Don't get me wrong. I'm really impressed with what you've accomplished.
I know, I have to.
But I'd really rather you not take off your oversized pants again.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Oh.
It's just not really dinner.
No, no, you're right. It's not. I was trying to answer.
Thank you.
But check out these bad boys!
There's no way that actually happened.
You think I can make that up?
No, 300 pounds is impressive, though.
I do.
So, remind me why we're putting ourselves through this again?
Didn't you know that you're not?
No, I mean, horrible blind dates that lead nowhere.
Hey, once I get to that, soon you'll be able to get your own bathroom and send me SOS texts from the bathroom.
I hope so.
And when that time comes, you have to type head first without thinking twice. My grandma used to always say, you can't nibble at Halloween, you have to do it in one bite.
Your voice would probably be a lot more effective if I could hear you.
Hey, guys!
Thank you for coming!
Right foot, let's stop. Left foot, let's stop. Freeze!
Everybody clap your hands!
You have a phobia of nursing home and peacocks.
You love black liquors, but hate Twizzlers. And your blood type? That's AB positive. We didn't know that until I told you, because you've never given blood. Ask me something hard.
I don't know whether to be impressed or freaked out, but I think I'm just freaked out.
Have you ever heard of the internet? I bet you only use it for email.
Actually, yeah.
Seriously, what are you, trapped in 2021?
You found all of that about me online?
Of course. Why else do you think they invented Google, Facebook, Tumblr, eHarmony, Match.com, LinkedIn, Snapchat, Instagram, TikTok, Visa, and Ticketmaster?
Ticketmaster?
You bought 2 tickets to the Kenny Chesney concert in the summer of 2019.
Okay, so tell me about you.
Seriously, who doesn't research your date in advance? Do your homework. Here, I'll wait.
In a world where anything can happen, one man goes on a date with a woman.
It's nice to meet you too.
Once in a lifetime, a woman comes along that changes us forever. She's from the mean streets of South Central.
Actually, South Dakota.
He's a renegade cop.
You mean renegade cop?
Together, they might just make the perfect pair.
Okay, what's...
From Marvel Studios, the producers that brought you Endgame, comes a conversation 45 seconds in the making.
Okay, stop. Is there a reason why you're making an impression of that movie trailer voice?
That voice is mine.
That's you? That's your job?
It is.
Okay, that's pretty cool. So it'll be less weird if you just talk to me in a normal speaking voice.
I've been the official movie preview voice for so long that I've forgotten how to speak like a normal person.
Uh-huh.
It's made life harder than you think. I find it difficult to show emotion. For example, here's what it sounds like when I say something exciting. I can't believe my team won the Super Bowl. What about that catch and the game-winning drive? What a play. I'm freaking out. Ooh.
It does mean something in translation.
Or last week, when my friend's grandmother died, it was hard to sound sincere when I said this. I'm sorry for your loss. Rams was a wonderful woman. My condolences to you and your family.
It must be hard for you.
It's made me clinically depressed.
Well, what if you try to fix your problem?
I'm fairly certain it can't be fixed.
We could try. Here, give me an example from one of your movie trailers.
In a world where anything can happen, one man takes on...
Okay, there. Try saying in a world again.
In a world.
Right, but this time, say like I did. In a world.
In a world.
Better, try again.
In a world.
Maybe try saying inside the planet.
In a world.
Alright, forget it. I can't say if you're gonna talk like this.
Wait, before you go, can you do me one favor?
What?
Can you give me a ride home?
You don't have a car?
I can't afford a car.
You can't afford a car. You're a Hollywood celebrity. Shouldn't you have a lot of money?
In a world of million-dollar makeovers and plastic surgery, one man risked it all. And now he's broke and lives with his mom.
Hi, Brooke, right?
Yes.
It's nice to meet you.
Yes.
So this place looks pretty cool.
Yes.
You've been here before?
Yes.
Really good?
Yes.
Oh, well, that's good to hear.
Yes.
So you live downtown, right?
Yes.
Do you like it?
Yes.
Did you say anything other than yes?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
Are you going to tell me?
No.
Oh. You speak English, right?
Yes.
Ah, great food.
Yes.
Wait, you said more than yes, right?
Do I say more than yes?
Okay, good. Never mind. I'll have the chicken salad entree with the gazpacho to start.
Ma'am? Yes. Can I get you something?
Yes.
Here, allow me. Do you want an appetizer?
No.
Soup?
No.
Salad?
Yes.
Caesar salad?
No.
Garden salad?
Yes.
Dressing?
Yes.
Can you help me out here?
Yes. Blue cheese?
No.
French?
No.
Ranch?
No.
Reduced fat ranch?
No.
Low fat ranch?
No.
Balsamic vinaigrette?
Yes.
Mixed in?
No.
On the side?
Yes.
We have 34 entrees to choose from. Would you like the grilled salmon?
No.
Roast chicken?
No.
Spare ribs?
No.
Duck all around?
You know what? Why don't we just start with the salad for now?
Very good, sir.
Is everything okay?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. Is that why you're only answering with yes or no?
Yes.
Did I tell you anything?
Yes.
Did you say anything else? answer's been corresponding to my questions at all?
Yes.
Okay, what's 2 plus 2?
Yes.
What's the capital of Oregon?
No.
Do you kick puppies for a living?
Yes.
What's your opinion on random words like Triceratops, Dodgeball, or Miley Cyrus?
No, yes, yes.
So I think the real question is, Italiano, Francais, Espanol?
Rapaño, gracia a Dios, me de cuenta. Como falta profecía, salir con hombre. Si significa Rapaño, pero generalmente, yo no soy aposentada, ¿qué posible esto?
¿Sí?
No, I completely agree.
And yet somehow it's a high freak show on television.
Seriously, I thought I was the only one bothered by that.
Same here. You know, this is great.
It is.
We have the same tastes, same politics, same values.
Same religion, same characters.
We're from the same part of the country.
Pretty unbelievable.
That's not bad, right, to have too much in common?
No, I think that's good. Unless you also shoot.
Shoot for so different.
Oh well. I've been thinking. I know the rule says we should wait a few days before scheduling the next meeting, but...
No, we should just schedule it now.
Really?
Yeah, definitely.
Alright, well, I can't just be mine or... yeah.
Me neither. Not to be Debbie Downer, but I have a family to go to.
Oh, really? So do I. Family's gonna come.
Same here. Yeah, my cousin Trudy have like 100 cousins.
That's weird. The funeral I'm going to is for my cousin. A minute, are you?
It's your dad. Oh, seriously?
This is going great. You know, this reminds me of this story where my best friend went on this really awesome date, and the date turned out to be your cousin. Seriously.
Hi.
Hi. Thanks for being on such short notice.
No worries.
Shall we get started?
Sure.
I recently underwent a failed merger with my previous client. What I'm looking for at this stage is a complete overhaul of the status quo, a paradigm shift taking us from relationship to relationship 2.0. Please hold your questions to the end. Now, as we see in these projections, my 4-year plan is to hit the ground running with a strong foundation in the first 3 quarters, synergizing from the word go, and by 2025 have fully reinvented our relationship using a scalable approach to seamless integration. Now, how do I plan to do this? I will tell you. Thinking outside the box, win-win situations, giving 110%, maximizing leverage, pushing the envelope, squaring the circle, and finally, making sure to call ahead if one of us is going to be late for a movie or something. I think you'll agree that as a disruptive innovation, this is a value-added proposition. Now, if we run up the flagpole to see who's to lose, if we stay to where the puck is going, if we stick a fork in it to see if it's done, if we tickle the artichoke until it sings Dancing Queen, then I guarantee that this merger will bear fruit. And by fruit, I'm of course in no way talking about babies. Unless you would want to talk about it, but also cool if not. I'm all for it. Any questions?
I do have one question.
You?
Could you tell me how possible that I've actually had more space than this one?
They didn't use pie charts, huh?
I'm gonna go hit the link. Oh, hey, what are you doing here? I was just texting you. Save me.
Save me, too. So, I thought for a long time about what you said at the wedding, or what you screamed at the wedding. I realized that for 2 years I've been texting you escape plans from the bathroom, but never went in with you.
Me too. Like, all I could think about now was us doing laundry together instead of listening to whatever garbage this guy was talking about.
How's it going?
So, I think we should stop nibbling at that whole opinion. We should just eat the whole thing, which sucks because I'm allergic to pepper. What I'm asking is, will you come to dinner with me?
Yes.
But not just one dinner. All the dinners.
Oh, check please.
Thank you.
to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? Till the end of time. So you got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? It's always titties, titties, titties. Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay or should I go now? If I go, there will be trouble. And if I stay, it will be trouble. So come on and let me know. Come on, let me know. Should I cool it or should I blow?
They all went up.